David had been anointed king over Israel. They went up in full force to search him, but David heard about it and went out to meet them. Now the Philistines had come and raided the valley of Rephaim. So David inquired of God, "Shall I go and attack the Philistines? Will you deliver them into my hands?" The Lord answered him, "Go, I will deliver them into your hands." So David and his men went out to Baal Perazim, and there he defeated them. He said, "As waters break out, God has broken out against my enemies by my hand." So that place was called Baal Perazim. The Philistines had abandoned their gods there, and David gave orders to burn them in the fire.
Y volviendo los filisteos a extenderse por el valle, David volvió a consultar a Dios, y Dios le dijo, "No subas tras ellos, sino rodéalos, para venir a ellos por delante de las balsameras. Y así que oigas venir un estruendo por las copas de las balsameras, sal luego a la batalla, porque Dios saldrá delante de ti y herirá el ejército de los filisteos." Hizo pues David como Dios le mandó, y derrotaron al ejército de los filisteos desde Gabaón hasta Geser. Y la fama de David fue divulgada por todas aquellas tierras, y Jehová puso el temor de David sobre todas las naciones.
Once more the Philistines raided the valley, so David inquired of God again, and God answered him, "Don't go directly after them, but circle around them and attack them in front of poplar trees. As soon as you hear the sound of marching in the tops of the poplar trees, move out to battle, because that will mean God has gone out in front of you, you to strike the Philistines' army." So David did as God commanded him, and they struck down the Philistines' army all the way from Gibeon to Gezer. So David's fame spread out through the land, and the Lord made all the nations fear him.
Gracias, Señor, por tu palabra.
Thank you, Lord, for your word.
Gracias, Señor, porque nos vas a usar con poder y autoridad.
Thank you, Lord, because you're going to use us with power and authority.
Para bendecir tus hijos.
To bless your children.
Yo quiero que usted preste mucha atención.
I want you to pay a lot of attention.
Estamos en un tiempo de batalla.
We're in a time of battle.
Muy estratégico.
That is a strategic time.
Hay que ser sabio.
You have to be wise.
Con las bendiciones.
With the blessings.
Y hay que ser inteligente.
And you have to be intelligent.
Con lo que tú estás haciendo.
With what you're doing.
Tus decisiones,
your decisions,
fuera de la voz de Dios,
out of the voice of God,
te pueden llevar al fracaso.
It could take you to failure.
Aún buenas decisiones,
even good decisions,
te pueden llevar a la ruina.
Can take you to ruins.
¿Me está entendiendo?
Are you understanding me?
Aún buenas decisiones,
even good decisions,
pueden llevarte a la derrota.
Can take you to defeat.
Lo primero que yo quiero que tú entiendas,
the first thing that I want you to understand,
es que tú naciste para conquistar.
Is that you were born to conquer.
Eso es algo que yo voy a poner en tu pensamiento.
That's something that I'm going to put in your thoughts.
Hasta que tú conquistes.
Until you conquer.
Hasta que tú logres lo que tú quieres
until
lograr.
Until you accomplish what you want to accomplish.
Pero hay algo,
but there's something
que se llama,
that is called
ungido.
Anointed.
Hay algo que se llama escogido.
There's something that is called chosen.
Hay algo que se llama,
there's something that is called
hijos de Dios.
Children of God.
Una vez tú entras en esa atmósfera,
once you enter into that atmosphere,
tú tienes que entender,
you have to understand,
que si comienzas a hacer algo,
that if you start doing something,
tu nombre,
your name,
será mencionado.
Is going to be mentioned.
Mira a alguien y dile,
look at somebody and say,
mi nombre será mencionado.
My name will be mentioned.
No, pero con ese ánimo.
No, but not with that energy.
Estoy escuchando en este lado mucho.
I'm speaking, I'm hearing it a lot louder on this side.
A
I want everybody like that.
Cuando tú comienzas a entrar en la atmósfera,
when you start entering into the atmosphere,
de muerte a vida,
from death to
las
life,
tinieblas,
the darkness,
no te tocan,
it doesn't touch you,
pero te rodean,
but it surrounds you.
¿Entendiste?
Did you understand me?
Entonces, al no tocarte,
so because it can't touch you,
se levanta el celo,
the jealousy arises,
se levanta la envidia,
the emptiness arises,
se levantan los argumentos,
the arguments arise.
Como las tinieblas no pueden tocarte,
and because the darkness cannot touch
tiene
you,
que levantar a tus enemigos,
it has to lift up your enemies,
para que ellos lleguen a ti,
so that they could make it to
pero
you,
tus enemigos,
but your enemies,
se pueden convertir en amigos,
they could be converted into friends.
Espérate, ahí el yo-yo subió y bajó.
Wait a minute, the yo-yo went up and down there.
tus enemigos,
your enemies,
en una temporada se pueden convertir en tus amigos.
In a season, they could turn into your friends.
Y lo que sucede,
and what happens,
es que le das acceso a las tinieblas.
Is that you give access to the darkness.
Oye esto,
I want you to
los
listen.
Filisteos,
the Philistines,
no habían subido,
they had not gone
ni
up.
Habían hecho nada,
they had not done anything.
Hasta que se enteraron,
until they found
cuando
out.
Un hombre está marcado.
When a man is marked.
Déjame repetir.
Let me repeat it.
Cuando tú llegas al lugar donde tú estás,
when you make it to the place where you're at,
es como la gente cuando llega nuevo a un trabajo.
It's like the people when they get new, they're new at the job.
Los empleados que llevan tiempo, que lo que han hecho es perder tiempo.
The employees that have been there for a long time, all they've done is just
llega
waste time.
Llega alguien nuevo con hambre.
If somebody new comes
llega
with
alguien
hunger,
con deseo.
Somebody with desires.
Llega alguien con anhelo de
somebody
progresar.
With desire of progressing.
Automáticamente.
Automatically.
Cambia la atmósfera de ese lugar.
It changes the atmosphere of that place.
No tienes compañeros de trabajo.
You don't have coworkers.
Tienes envidiosos.
You have envious people.
Celosos.
Jealous people.
Contra ti.
Against you.
Ellos no te lo van a dejar ver.
They're not going to let you see it.
Pero te van a rodear.
But they're going to surround you.
Se van a cuidar.
They're going to be careful.
Todo lo que pase será tu culpa.
Everything that happens is going to be your fault.
¿Por qué?
Why?
Porque cuando la mano de Dios te toca.
Because when the hand of God touches
te bendice,
and it blesses
you. Automáticamente donde hayan tinieblas tú
brillas. Where there's darkness, you're shining.
Si usted lo cree, diga amén.
If you believe it, say amen.
Si no, pues, no lo diga.
If not, don't say it.
Pero cuando usted va a marcar la diferencia,
but when you're going to mark the difference,
cuando tú vas a hacer algo,
when you're going to do something,
cuando Dios va a hacer algo contigo,
when God is going to do something with
tienes
you,
que prepararte,
you have to get prepared.
Porque tú vas a tener que aprender a pelear a la buena o a la mala.
Because you're going to have to learn how to fight whether you want it in
vas
a good term or not.
Convertirte en un guerrero en una guerrera.
You're going to have to convert yourself into a warrior.
Vas a tener que aprender a llorar tirando puños.
You're going to have to learn how to cry but throwing punches.
Parece que hay muchos sueños.
It seems like I'm the only one.
Parece que no han tomado la vitamina.
It seems like you have not drank any vitamins.
Después de este comienzo de esta celebración.
After this beginning, this celebration.
Porque esto es un movimiento que si no es el espíritu la carne tú te puedes tirar tu paso.
Because if this is a movement that if there's no spirit you can just take your step.
Entonces, cuando te digan en la carne, no digan que es pecado.
And when they say in the flesh, don't say it's a sin.
No.
No.
En tu humanidad.
It's in your humanity.
Pablo dijo, y todo lo que hago en mi carne.
Paul said, everything that I do in my flesh.
Lo hago para adorar y celebrar y honrar.
I do it to worship, to celebrate, and to praise the name of the Lord.
Ahora, mira esto. Look at this. Cuando Dios
when God
decides hacer algo contigo,
to do something with you,
¿te has dado cuenta que nosotros nos parecemos pero no somos iguales?
Haven't you noticed that we're similar but we're not the same?
Tenemos dos manos.
We have two hands. Two eyes.
Sin embargo,
however,
tenemos muchas cosas diferentes.
We have many things that are different.
Si la gente entendiera,
if the people would understand,
que la omnipresencia,
that omnipresence,
la omnipotencia,
the omnipotent,
y omnisciente,
and omniscient,
de Dios,
of God,
somos todos nosotros.
It is all of us.
Lo que pasa es,
but what happens
que el ser humano no se ha dado cuenta de la capacidad,
is that the human beings have not noticed the
capacity
that God has deposited within them.
Cuando tú no descubres realmente lo que tú vas a hacer,
and when you truly don't discover what you're going to do,
tú no te conviertes en amenaza.
You don't convert yourself into a
pero
threat.
Cuando Dios te unge,
but when God anoints you,
mira el que está a tu lado y dile, eres ungido.
Look at the one that's next to you and say, you're anointed, you're anointed.
Tú eres escogido.
You're chosen.
¿Sabes? No te creas que el pastor tiene más.
You know, don't think that the pastor has more than the apostle.
Aquí está Dios y Dios trabaja con todos.
God is here and God works with everyone.